How did you establish a relationship with a member, and did you fully express your interest to them, or did they already know? Grad chapters are a little bit different. Like, they're not like undergrad, and people have this misconception a lot. Grad chapter, the women, or I can only speak for my chapter, but the women are a little bit more laid back and interested in what your goals are and what you plan on doing for the community, what you plan on doing to give back. Like, they're more interested in what all chapters are, what you can bring to the chapter and what you can bring to the sorority, and your skills and your talents and what your goals are for the next 5 years. Like, they're more interested in business aspects, in a sense. No, I'm not a legacy. My aunt is the one that's in the chapter. My mom is not a part of any sorority. My dad is a Kappa, and my brother is a Kappa, so he's a legacy, but not me. Thank you for letting me know that I need to lower my background music, sis. Grad chapter is a different beast. How long did you express interest to your chapter before you were invited for MIP? I honestly don't remember the timeline, because like I said, my aunt was in the chapter, and then like she introduced me to a couple of the ladies. And for all grad chapters, you have to have a sponsor, is what we call our big sisters. So I'm just using general terms here, but my sponsor, she knew my aunt, and yeah, it just kind of went from there. I don't know if it was like 2 or 3 months before I was invited. I don't know. It's just because, like I said, it's some things that I can and can't say. But it also depends on the chapter. So you can be expressing interest for a year and they not have a chapter in that year span, but they might have a chapter after a year, or they might have a chapter after you start expressing interest within 6 months. But grad chapters are just like undergrad chapters of when they cross a chapter. You have fall, summer, and spring. Our chapter crossed in fall last year. So it's like, the timeline is unexpected, but you know, when November comes around, that's when most undergrad chapters and other graduate chapters start dropping lines or having ceremonies. So it's just, like you said, it's a different beast in a way, but we still follow the same like timeline as undergraduate chapters. Did I know anybody at my current chapter before you became a member? Did you start out fresh as an interest? And I already answered that. It's my aunt. So, Rosé and politics. Hey, Monet, quick question. I'm a grad student, and I know other student and faculty members at my school that are AKAs. Is it appropriate for me to speak to them to show interest in their grad chapter? I know you have to be invited, so I'm wondering, should I tell them that I'm interested? Any suggestions? Thank you. And that's the last question. But I responded to her. And yes, you should express your interest to them. Like I said, graduate members are a little bit more laid back. Like, they're not tense on you. Like, I don't know. Like, they don't want you to be intimidated by them. So that's what I was gonna say. Yes, you should express your interest to them. My story with getting more interested into grad chapter was, I looked up, when I got to USF, I already knew like I wouldn't be considered an undergraduate student because I already had my bachelor's degree. So I was considered like post-bac student, and in order to pledge, like, they're really strict on you cannot be, if you have a four-year degree, you have to go into a graduate chapter. If you have not completed your four-year degree and you haven't received a bachelor's, then you do undergrad. So if you have a degree, you gotta do grad. Like, you can't go back to school and do undergrad because you're not considered an undergraduate student. Unless you've, like, never, ever gone. So what I did was I looked up, because they always have a directory. They always have a place where you can find out who's in that chapter and who is, like, a graduate advisor. That's who it is. So all undergraduate chapters have to have a graduate advisor. And I went on the website, found out who their graduate advisor was, because they had a picture of her. And I would see her, like, at the Greek events. And I already talked to, like, a few of the AKAs at USF that I knew. And I was just like, hey, do you know who I could talk to about me already having a graduate degree, but I'm pursuing another undergraduate degree? I was like, how does that work? And they told me that I would probably have to do grad chapter, but they suggested that I speak to the graduate advisor before I kind of pursue it more. So I saw her at an event. I told her who I was. I talked to her a little bit and she helped me out. But then I started expressing my interest to my aunt, and I was like, hey, I'm in nursing school in Tampa, but I wanna do grad chapter. I was like, do you know anybody that's in Tampa? And she didn't know anybody. But eventually I ended up coming back home and I just did my chapter in Orange Park, Florida. So, needless to say, grad chapter is different. Like, we want you to approach us. We want you to show interest and show that you care about the community outside of your undergraduate career. So if you see a grad chapter member, don't be intimidated. Some women are, some women aren't, but that's just how it is. And I hate to say it, and I hated to hear people say it, but now that I can say it, I understand it. But at the end of the day, you want to be a part of my organization, so I mean, show me why. But yeah, that's it for this Q&A. Thank you guys so much for 500 subscribers. If you watched all the way to the end of this video without subscribing, I don't know why you didn't do it.
So you should probably hit that subscribe button.
But yeah, y'all, I'm about to go eat some more of this Thanksgiving food and edit this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch y'all next month in a couple of days. And I'll be introducing some new things to my channel. So stay tuned for that. Make sure you follow me on social media, on Instagram, because I post on Instagram more than I post on here. But yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.